My friends, as we continue our sermon series, Biblical Bullies, our second text for today comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 8, beginning with the 31st verse. Now, of course, before I read it, know what I'm going to ask. Bible check. Wonderful, 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 wonderful. So glad that you are bringing your Bibles. This is what we encourage, especially when we gather together here in the house of the Lord, that you bring your Bibles when it's time for us to read God's Word. Excuse me. Again, I'll be reading the Gospel of John, chapter 8, beginning with verse 31. Yeah. And then we'll go through the A portion of verse 41. This is what it says. To the Jews who had believed him, Jesus said, "If you hold to my teaching, you are really my disciples. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." They answered him, "We are Abraham's descendants and have never been slaves of anyone. How can you say that we shall be set free?" Jesus replied, "I tell you the truth. Everyone who sins is a slave to sin. Now, a slave has no permanent place in the family, but a son belongs to it forever. So if the son sets you free, you will be free indeed. I know you are Abraham's descendants, yet you are ready to kill me because you have no room for my word. I'm telling you what I have seen in the Father's presence, and you do what you have heard from your father. Abraham is our father," they answered. "If you were Abraham's children," said Jesus, "then you would do the things Abraham did. As it is, you are determined to kill me, a man who has told you the truth that I heard from God. Abraham did not do such things. You are doing the things your own father does." "We are not illegitimate children," they protested. "The only father we have is God himself." Tell you what, keep reading. I want to go to verse 44. And verse 42. "Now Jesus said to them, 'If God were your father, you would love me. For I came from God and now am here. I have not come on my own, but he sent me. Why is my language not clear to you? Because you are unable to hear what I say. You belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desire. He was a murderer from the beginning, not holding to the truth, for there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks his native language, for he is a liar and the father of lies.'" This, my friends, is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you today for your blessings and all that you've done. And for all that we've witnessed, for we know that you're using these things to prepare us to hear a word from you. So right now, make me less. Allow me to decrease so that you can increase and become more. And fix us by clearing our minds, opening our hearts, and unstopping our ears so we can hear from you. And upon hearing from you, we want to leave this place better than the way we arrived. Yes, Lord, we want to walk out of it better than the way we walked in. Through Christ we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you would, please turn to a neighbor. Look at them good and repeat after me. Friend.
Friend.
Today's sermon is called
The Biggest Bully.
Amen. The Biggest Bully. Jesus had his share of bullies. He did. But Satan is a bully of epic proportion, found in several passages in the Bible, but none favorable. Satan's goal is to fight against the will of God, which includes disrupting the lives of the children of God. And in this our sermonic text, Jesus shares the reason why these persons want to kill him. He says they're following the will of their father. No. Their father was not Abraham, as they claimed. Their father was not God either. Jesus says to them, you belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desires. Jesus says that their father was a murderer from the very beginning. And then he calls Satan the father of lies. The father of lies. Lies, right? Probably not the Father's Day sermon we were hoping to get. Probably not. I understand that. You know, I believe that the worst effect of bullying is psychological. You see, when a bully has you afraid, so afraid that you believe whatever the bully tells you, then the bully has you. When the bully says you're worthless, and I'm the only one who wants to love you, and it's hard for me to do it. When the bully says you're pathetic, just like whoever they want to call, and you'll never amount to anything, just like whoever they want to call. When the bully says, you know, one in five people is ugly. Your four friends are cute. So there's got to be a problem right here. It's possible. See, it's possible that you can physically be beaten by a person and actually grow somewhat immune to it. Go numb with it. But once the protective borders of your mind have been breached, once that happens, you will replay every negative thing that a bully says to you over and over again. The bully doesn't have to be in the room with you. The bully doesn't have to be in the same city as you're in. But you replay it over and over again in your mind. Satan is the biggest bully the world has ever known and will ever know. And I understand that other ancient cultures shared stories of an evil being that was circulated around the same time that the Bible was written. I got that. And I understand many Christians have chosen not to believe in Satan altogether. I understand that. And I'm not here to argue that with anyone. But I'll say this for me. I believe that there is an evil that exists well beyond our understanding. You know, the original version of the Lord's Prayer, the one that Jesus actually taught the disciples to pray, you know what it says? It does not say deliver us from evil. It says deliver us from the evil one. Deliver us from the evil one. And as Christians, my friends, we have to be careful when we decide to pick and choose what we're going to believe and what we're not going to believe. You see, because sometimes you've got to call it by its name. You can't dance around it. Play hide and seek with it. You got to name it as to what it is. Something's just wrong with my blood. It's not serious. No, it's cancer. And it is serious. No. He just loses control when he drinks. That's all. He loses control when he drinks and he yells and every once in a while he may hit me. It's not that big of a deal. It is a big deal. It's domestic violence and alcoholism. Stop playing as if it's not something real. It is a big deal. No, I'm not just a slow reader. I'm also a learner. I'll just keep going the way that I'm going. But it very well may be dyslexia and you need help. You need help. You see, the father of lies will tell you anything. Just to keep you in bondage. Just to be able to continue to bully you into whatever he wants. Yes. Today's Father's Day. It is. It is. I spent time with Pop on yesterday and the day before. Got up this morning. My kids had cards for me. We got to do some traveling, so my wife told me that any big celebration will happen later on, and my daughter quickly said, but we're going to be in Florida, so we just take Dad to the beach, and that's free. She's going to take care of me when I'm old, y'all. Today's Father's Day. This is the day where we give Dad good neckties, socks. Today is Father's Day. Today is the day when those of us who have fathers who are horrible, that we remember them and we may even hate them all the more. Father's Day. But Jesus tells this group, if God were your father, you would love me. You would love me. For I came from God. And now am here. And I've not come on my own, but I've been sent. God has sent me. Then he says, basically, but you can't believe this, can you? This is not the first time I've told you this. I've told you this before, and you can't believe this. You can't hear this because your actual daddy is feeding you lies. Lies about me. And lies about you. Lies about my purpose. And about my interests. Lies about my origin. And then around verse 47, which was not a part of our sermonic text, Jesus says, he who belongs to God hears what God says. And the reason why you do not hear is because you do not belong to God. An easy lesson, of course not. Of course not. Let me tell you one of the things that I love about my Lord and Savior. Sometimes, due to who I am and my personality, you've got to really hit me hard for me to get it. You can't dance around parent and expect me to pick up on it. Sometimes you just got to come right on out and say it. And Jesus spends a lot of time talking to me and talking to you in this exact manner. So listen, please. You see, what Jesus is saying is this. If God is your Father, there's some things you can't easily do. Or do it all. You see, it's hard to hate. It's hard to hate when God is your Father. It's hard to hold grudges when God is your Father. It's hard to hear what's right and then do what's wrong when God is your Father. You know, it's hard to mistreat people. and maybe even harder to watch people be mistreated when God is your Father. It's hard to be angry, especially all the time. Well, you run into folks like that. Every time you see them, they're mad. It's hard to be angry and mad all the time when the God of love, the one who is love, is your Father. And it's hard to fight all of the time. Lord have mercy. I'm on my way to a church meeting, and every time I go to church meetings, sometimes there's a little level of anxiety that rises up in me. Because I've not yet gotten to the point where I can go to a church meeting and not expect to see a fight. I've seen so many, some verbal and some with fists. God can't be your Father. God can't be your Father if you fight all of the time. But listen closely. If we find any of these to be easy to do, and we continue to call ourselves children of God, well, you just may have been lied to by the biggest bully. Blessed today.